Hi, I'm Trisha Peterson, and you're watching Channel 7 News.
Channel 7, bringing the news to you fast.
So, Billy Waters here says he has a new change of government he is looking to find. Billy, could you tell us more on that? Thanks, Trisha. It's Bill Waters here. I actually just wanted to correct Trisha on some things. I just wanted to sort of establish what we are as a nation, and I think we should do that by adding this to the Constitution. This will really just state what we are. It will in fact include that we are the people of the United States, and that in order to form a more perfect union and establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty, like everything that we already want. Just to ourselves and our posterity, you know, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren, everyone. We do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. I think we should just make it a Constitution. And I think that's a necessary change, and it needs to be done. Well said, Bill. I think that new change is a little bit rambunctious, but exciting. After Shay's Rebellion, we could really use something like that. Do you propose this replace the Articles of Confederation, or sort of exist alongside it? Yes, Trisha, I actually do believe this. I think it should replace the Articles of Confederation, as it is a stronger government, and that's what America needs at this time. It needs us to come together and sort of just work together as a nation. I think that's what we could really need. Well put, Bill. Anyways, this has been Channel 7 News on changes to the Articles of Confederation and a brand new constitution. Bill Waters has spilled some new insight on us, and we think it's exciting. Tune in next time for Congress. Is it necessary? Bicameral? You'll find out. Wait. Start the camera. So, Tim, are you getting this? So Bill Waters was not the only one that we have information from. We have 7 new principles that want to be introduced to this new constitution. Tim, keep on rolling. This is about to get spicy.
Hi, I'm Popular Server Ryan T, and I'm one of the first principles of the government. There are 7 total, but I'm the wackiest. I want people to control the government. That means a limited government. Government controlled by the people, which is obviously a plus, because who wouldn't want to control the way they live? And overall, it means we choose the way that our new nation rolls out. That's my pitch.
Hi, Trisha. I'm a republic form of government, and I'm gonna get right down to it, because that's how I want this government to be. In the republic form of government, you vote for elected officials to represent you in government. It's that easy. You just need representation. And that's one of the key principles of this new constitution. We want to be represented and our voices need to be heard. Thanks, Trisha.
Hey, I'm Federalism. And in my principle, there's different levels of government that can function. There's the enumerated powers, which are the federal powers, the powers that the whole country has, and then there's the reserved powers, which the states have. These can boil down to state powers, like creating banks, listing schools, or this can come down to country powers, which are also known as the enumerated powers, as I mentioned before. These can come down to interstate criminal, interstate trade, establishing war. Any of these principles really fall under the main umbrella that is federalism. And federalism is a very broad topic and should obviously be included in the Constitution.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm limited government. I'm very similar to popular sovereignty, but not quite. So,
limited government, it's controlled by the people, just like popular sovereignty. But in limited government, its powers are listed. That's the importance of this principle in the Constitution, which is why it should so obviously be included. That's a wrap, folks. Back to you, Trisha. Yo, Trisha. You know me. I'm separation of powers. You know what that means? I want to go in three branches. Those three branches are as follows: judicial, legislative, and executive. Executive executes laws. Legislative makes them. Judicial interprets them. That's all I gotta say. Listen up. If you think that this is bad, then you're a phony. Drop the mic. So sorry about that. Separation of powers seems to be a little bit extreme. So, anyways, moving on. Now we have checks and balances. Let's hear what his deal is, huh? Hi, I'm Checks and Balances. Sorry about the outburst from my, her partner, but we kind of work hand in hand, so I guess you can say we complete each other. I am sort of the balance, as my name implies, between the three branches that my partner mentioned. Really, it's just to make sure that neither one overpowers the other. This is kind of important in the Constitution, and by kind of, I mean really important, because otherwise we would just have corruption left and right. So, I guess in my partner's words, if you don't think so, then you a phony. Hi. I'm individual rights. I really don't see why I wouldn't be in the Constitution, because I'm pretty much crucial to everyone's existence. As you can probably tell, and as you've heard, my existence is heavily emphasized by everyone in the nation. I am the basis of what makes you human. I am the basis of our everyday life. I am your right to freedom. I am your right to liberty. I am your right to everything. If I'm not in the Constitution, you're not in a free nation. Anyways, back to you, Trisha. Okay, so thanks for coming to this emergency segment of Channel 7 News. This has been urgent changes to the Constitution that need to be emphasized. The Articles of Confederation, as shown by Bill Waters and the Seven Concepts, are just not viable anymore. If we want to survive as a nation, we need these. Thanks for watching, everybody. This has been Trisha Peterson, Channel 7 News, where you get the news fast.
Channel 7, bringing the news to you fast.